Today, I'm going to show you how to measure the velocity of a stream. But before we get started, I need to choose a suitable site. Ideally, we want a site with the following characteristics. The less it is, the better, so our flotation device does not get stuck. This could muck up the results. I also want to avoid sites that have obstructions, such as logs, that might obstruct the flow of the stream. Also, take great caution, as streams can look pretty, but they can quickly become very dangerous environments. Never enter the stream if it is raining, as a flash flood could come out of nowhere. To do this, I'm going to need the following equipment. I'm going to need a couple of measuring tapes, one to do the length of the stream, and the other for the finish line. I'm also going to need a stopwatch for timing the ball as it floats down the stream. I'm going to need a flotation device such as a tennis ball or an orange. I'm also going to need at least three assistants. I need one assistant at each end of our tape, and I also need someone who's going to record the data. It is also useful to have some pre-drawn data tables already. As a rule, the more attempts you take throwing the objects into the water, the more reliable results are likely to be. Small sample sizes will throw up unreliable results. So now, let's go measure the stream. Now first, let us measure out a decent distance along the stream bank. For example, let's say 20 metres. Now in hydrology, we call this the reach. Now upstream, I have one of my assistants who's standing there with a stopwatch and the tennis ball ready to throw it in. Now someone else will be at the bottom of the reach to catch the tennis ball. In this case, it will be me. Now throw the tennis ball into the stream and start timing. When the tennis ball passes the lower boundary of the reach, the person at the bottom will yell or signal to the person at the top to stop the stopwatch. Stop the stopwatch! Now record the time and distance travelled. Now you're going to repeat this process at least three times or otherwise until you are satisfied you have enough samples. For example, I like to do this 10 times to make my readings more valid. Now for the calculations. You will need to divide the average time of each journey by 0.85. This is because the water on the surface of the stream flows faster than the water beneath. Now, let's calculate the velocity.